Hello everyone. Fire Emblem. It's a thing. A series that I've played like one chapter of. And seen like half the story of Awakening-ish. Maddening difficulty? Nope. Goddess Tower? I don't know what that is. Event gallery I've seen after. Save slots. Go into battle with the same appearance as in the monastery. New ally will join in Crimson Flower. New outfit added for the protagonist and a new quest. If you clear the new quest, a new character will be available to invite to a tea party. All right. I don't like the way this is set up because normal looks like easy. But I don't know if that's actually the case. Is normal easy, or is it actually just we will not? This is not XCOM numbers mode. You know what? Let's just play on normal. Casual. Online features? Okay. It's only Fire Emblem at the obligatory character, like, torching. No, I do not have the DLC. I don't know if I like the game enough to get the DLC. This is really weird. Like, it's trying to look 2D, even though it's clearly using the 3D models. For most of it. Yeah, that's also true on my end. There we go. Not, it doesn't matter a ton right now, but.
Die. Die. You took everything. that I loved.
I have not seen this bounty ad that I've heard about. Oh no.
I wonder how you got in here.
Oh, that is Morgana's voice actress, huh?
It is most rude to interrupt a moment of repose. Very rude indeed. Now come to me. I wish to have a look at you.
I just like Girl Byleth's look better.
I have not seen the likes of you before. Who are you anyway?
Why is that emote Danny DeVito called Myth? Why are you interrogating me? Alright, I'll just go my actual birthday, I guess.
Well, wonders never cease. It seems we share our day of birth. How strange. It all feels so familiar. I think it may be time for yet another nap.
Hey, time to wake up. Are you having that dream again?
Normal difficulty. What are these emotes? I mean, I was actually there for this one.
You've described her to me before. I don't think I've ever met anyone like that. In any case, just put that out of your mind for now. Battlefield is no place for idle thoughts.
See, I've heard some things about Edelgard or Red. So I feel like I kinda should do that route first. Edelgard? I'll hear it. I should do that one first just to get the actual background there. Oh, Adele. Got it. I could be Tom. Yeah, see, that's why I'm like, okay, I should probably actually find out what the deal there is. I don't understand how that thing Triss sent me is supposed to be, topical.
Risking your life is part of the job for mercenaries like us. Letting your mind wander is a sure way to get yourself killed. Okay, time to get moving. Our next job is in the kingdom. I told you before, it's far from here, so we'll need to leave at dawn. Everyone is already waiting for us outside.
Oh god, you raise support stuff just from normal conversations?
Gerald, sir, sorry to barge in, but your presence is needed.
What's happened?
Swiss Army Marth.
Please forgive our intrusion. We wouldn't bother you with the situation not dying.
I don't know. I feel like we already have one from here with Byleth.
What do a bunch of kids like you want at this hour?
We're being pursued by a group of bandits. I can only hope that you will be so kind as to lend your support.
Bandits? Here?
It's true. They attacked us while we were at rest in our camp.
We've been separated from our companions and we're outnumbered. They're after our lives, not to mention our gold.
I'm impressed you're staying so calm considering the situation. Wait, the uniform.
Bandit spotted just outside the village. Damn, there are a lot of them.
I guess they followed you all the way here. We can't abandon this village now. Come on, let's move. Hope you're ready.
Oh, I like that sprite of presumably Byleth. Oh! Oh! That's actually really neat. Alright, prologue chapter.
Let's take care of those thieves before they overrun the village. Take down the enemies in front first. That should take the wind out of their sails.
Let's see here. Thief with an iron sword. Iron sword, iron sword, iron sword. So they're all sword except for the boss, who is axe.
Ready and willing.
Yeah, you just do that. Okay, I didn't expect you to move forward considering you have a bow. Weapon will break with repeated use. Right, weapon durability. You can fight with a broken weapon, but your might and hit rate will be reduced. Enemies might follow attacks more easily. Be careful with your weapons. You cannot repair them mid-battle, but you can repair them.
I'll cut through.
Your strength. Let's work together to drive out these thieves.
I assume I... Wait a second. I was about to say, oh, I assume that I can just only worry about talking to named characters, but I remember specifically in Path of Radiance that there was a random guard you could talk to in one of the first chapters. Or Path of Radiance is the Wii one, I think. So, you guys are all just generic thieves. None of you have anything interesting except Costas. Oh.
I will prevail. You have a strange aura about you. You say you're a mercenary, so show me what you can do. Stay focused.
I mean, like, a unique model.
I'm not dead right now. Thanks for that. I didn't expect to run into mercenaries like you in some remote village. The gods of fortune must be smiling on me.
Oh, I was expecting to be able to use Geralt there. Let's see.
We'll advance while protecting ourselves from the enemy. Take up position inside the forest.
Certain terrain will have different effects, right? Move your units to advantageous terrain, prepare to meet the enemy. Let's see. There's no real advantageous terrain for you to move to while attacking. Let's just move you up combat arts. Curved shot. Oh, so I can actually shoot around corners. Okay.
Sorry, the victory is mine.
Yeah, I noticed that. Alright, let's try and have, like, units together. Oh. So you can't move everyone? Because I didn't do anything with Edelgard. Alright, yeah. Let's move you here.
Yes, good. If we're in the forest, we can sustain their attacks without losing the advantage.
Thickets and heal tiles. Yeah, like, I want to move you two together. And you two together. This is a bit intense for a tutorial fight, this music. Not typically allowed for follow-up attacks. Wait, when do I get a grid map? Like a mini-map. Units learn new combat arts when their weapon skill levels go up. There are no combat arts for reason or faith. Those skills grant magic instead. Inherent magic. Okay. Ah. Oh, noble. Leaders of highborn lineage. Many nobles are descended from the 10 elites, heroes of old. This class can use some magic. Commoner. Those of common birth who must compensate for a lack of noble privilege with tenacity can use some magic. And then there's Geralt. Paladin. An esteemed knight with a balance of high strength, defense, and resistance. This class can move again after taking certain actions. What's a paladin? Play it again. What's a paladin? Again. What's a paladin? Again. Alright, let's see if... Can I move you here? No. Oh, I see. So if I move you up here, he still can't quite attack. Okay. Oh, you're technically... Haha, I'm in danger. Okay, You're actually safe right here. Alright.
Attack when an ally is nearby, and the enemy will be intimidated, making them easier to hit.
Violet is good at describing a character in a non-spoilery way. Oh god, there is a lot of stuff to raise supports here. Yeah, you can just come over here to deal with him.
That is that.
I really like the transition from the actual, like, fight theme to the map theme and vice versa. Yeah, let's, Oh. Yeah, let's go for a curved shot here. That's not items. Claude is no longer in danger. So, Chipinchi, what's your... Can I, like, just check your... arts? Tempest Lance. Just a powerful lance attack. Melee range. More like no-hi-o.
Never underestimate an outsider. I expected as much.
Items. What is this terrain? Cannot be crossed. Okay. Oh, he has an item. I'm guessing is what that green icon means. Oh, you finally decided to join in, Gerald? Let's see. I'm going to get the item that's highlighted green in the unit's details display when you defeat them. Oh, it's the axe. Alright, there is not a good scenario right here, so I'm just gonna have you wait here, wait for this idiot to come over here. And have you two head up here. Okay, I'm a dumb. They are now in the forest. Nice of you to join in, Gerald. Please don't finish it. I need that experience for actual party members. So I think what I want to do is... attack you for the link.
Each battle, a chance to grow.
You're gonna have to sustain a linked counter, though. Hello, Triss.
Is that all?
As long as it's not the borderline type fucking that happens when Alu is in the stream sometimes, it's fine.
Hey, you with the blank stare! Out of my way!
Is Byleth healing when she attacks? Oof. Even I know that's a big oof.
What the? Aren't you Gerald the Blade Breaker? What's a renowned mercenary like you doing here?
I'm the one who should be complaining. I'm caught up in the mess you started.
Isn't that a series staple? Let's see here. Axe. So, axe beats sword, lance beats sword. No. Okay, sword beats axe. Look, I don't want to miss and then get countered.
We must all do our part.
There's no weapon trap? Why? That's weird. So, Edelgard is Alice, who has Die For Me.
Not able to recall my name until just now, and just like that it came to me. How odd. That look upon your face. Did you think me a child? A mere child who forgot her own name? Phooey! That child just saved your life. And what does that mean to you? Correct. You understand. You threw yourself before an axe to save just one young girl. Yet all is well, as I have stalled the flow of time for now. You would have died had I not intervened.
Just accept it and move on.
Is gratitude so much to ask? I did deem you worth saving, after all. Though it is only momentary, time has stopped. However did I manage that? When time begins again, the axe will tear into your flesh, and you will surely meet your end. How rude of you to drag me into this. What to do?
I'll just stay here and wait to die. Guess I'll die. Guylith. Guylith.
Hey, over here.
We're not dealing with the basement dwellers because we don't have the DLC. Okay.
It is you. Goodness, it's been ages. Don't you recognize me? It's Alois, your old right-hand man. Well, that's how I always thought of myself anyway. Oh, it must have been 20 years ago that you went...
Exposition, exposition, exposition!
I always knew you were still alive.
haven't changed a bit, Alois. Just as loud as ever. And drop that captain nonsense. I'm not your captain anymore. These days, I'm just a wandering mercenary. One who has work to do. Goodbye, old friend.
Right. Goodbye, Captain. Wait, that isn't how this ends. I insist that you return to the monastery with me.
Garrig Mach Monastery. I suppose this was inevitable.
And how about you, kid? Are you the captain's child? Is that so? Well, physical differences aside, your mannerisms do remind me of the captain. I'd love for you to see the monastery too. You will join me, won't you? What's troubling you, Captain? You aren't about to run off again, are you?
Even I wouldn't dare run from the Knights of Saros.
Knights of Saros? They do seem rather skilled. It seems your presence is required. Get going. I appreciate your help.
Oh.
Your skill is beyond question. You're clearly an experienced mercenary. And your father, that would be Geralt, the Bladebreaker? Former captain of the Knights of Saros, oft praised as the strongest knight to ever live. Have I missed anything? How curious. I'd wager the explanation for that is fascinating indeed.
Hey, you are coming with us to the monastery, right? Of course you are. I'd love to.
Yes, we've established that.
I should mention that the three of us are students of the Officers' Academy at Garrig Mach Monastery.
I mean, that the name is literally an anagram.
We were doing some training exercises when those bandits attacked. I definitely got the worst of it.
That would be because you ran off.
Too true. I was the first to make a strategic retreat. Everything would have worked out if these two hadn't followed me and ruined everything. Because of them, every single one of those bandits chased after us. Utterly ridiculous.
Okay, maybe tone it down a little bit at this point.
Ah, so that's what you were thinking, Clark. And here I thought you were acting as a decoy for the sake of us all.
His intentions were as clear as day. You will prove a lacking ruler.
This is the problem with streaming Fire Emblem.
I wonder how being completely predictable affects one's ability to wield power. Personally, as the embodiment of distrust, I'd say your little exchange smacks of naivete.
Me? Naive? Tell me, are you actually incapable of keeping quiet, or is your lack of self-awareness a condition of some sort?
In any case, forgive our digression. I must speak with you if you can spare a moment. The way you held your ground against the bandit's leader was captivating. Never lost control of the situation.
Sure, yeah, totally. Nope, no control loss here. Nope, nothing's weird here.
Why I must ask you to consider lending your services to the Empire. I might as well tell you now. I am no mere student. I am also the Adrestian Empire's...
Halt, Edelgard. Please,
Edelgard, got it.
Proposition. The Holy Kingdom of Fargus is in dire need of exceptional individuals like yourself. Please... do you consider returning to the kingdom with me?
Whoa there, you two sure are hasty. Trying to recruit someone you just met. Tactless, really. I was personally planning to develop a...
We didn't really do that much ourselves to deal with the Empire.
But it seems there's no time for niceties in this world. So, capable stranger, let's get right to it. Where does your allegiance lie?
Hmm. It seems one's place of birth is quite significant to them. Yet they are so
That's true.
Impressed by you that you may take your pick. Well.
I mean, since, as I said, I am going to do Edelgard's route first just to get the full thing, I might as well raise her support.
A wise choice. Though the Empire has fallen from its former glory, the other regions are merely offshoots that pale in comparison.
All right, that's enough with the small talk. It's time to head back to the monastery.
Looks like we'll have to pick this up another time.
My, my, they are in such a hurry. You know, each of the three is most unique.
So she's always evaluating me. He seems quite sincere, but I sense darkness lurking beneath. His easy smile is striking, but that smile doesn't reach his eyes. I'm a healer, but also relevant to, I forget her name, but the nurse character from The Outer Worlds. Smoke. Weed.
Great tree moon. Three houses.
Every day.
The icy winds of the Agma Mountains have begun to scatter, and the verdant fields once again spring to life across Fodlan, heralding the start of a new year. As they celebrate the dawning year, the people pray that they may realize their full potential. Just as a tiny sprout hopes to one day grow into a great tree. The continent of Fodlan, said to be protected by a revered goddess, has existed since time immemorial. Three ruling powers now control the land. In the south lies a region long held by a more than 1,000-year-old dynasty, the Adrestian Empire. Beyond its borders, to the frigid north.
I can't do the mill tank cry because I don't even know it off the top of my head.
The royal family and its knights. To the east, a league of nobles that heeds no king nor emperor rules what is called the Lester Alliance. Once consumed by a tempest of war and turmoil, Fodlan and these three mighty powers now exist in relative harmony.
This will be your first time at the monastery. I'd be happy to show you around.
It really is Fodlan in a nutshell. The good and the bad.
Like it or not, we'll be there soon.
Gotta say, I'm not a big fan of the mixed 3D, 2D animation.
time bring you here?
It's been years since I've last set eyes on this place. To be forced to see her now. You saw her in the courtyard earlier, didn't you? The Archbishop, Lady Rhea. As you know, the majority of folks in Fodlan are devout followers of the teachings of Seros. The leader of that ridiculously large religious organization is the Archbishop, Lady Rhea.
Thank you for your patience, General. My name is Setek. I am an advisor to the Archbishop.
Right. Hello.
It has been a long time, Gerald. I wonder, was it the will of the goddess that we have another chance meeting like this?
Forgive my silence all these years. Much has happened since we last spoke.
So I see. The miracle of fatherhood has blessed you. That is your child, is it not?
Yes. Born many years after I left this place. I wish I could introduce you to the mother of my child. I'm afraid we lost her to illness.
I see. My condolences. As for you, I heard of your valiant efforts from Alois. What is your name? A fine name indeed. From the bottom of my heart, I thank you for saving those students of the Officers' Academy. Gerald. You already know what it is I wish to say, do you not?
You want me to rejoin the Knights of Seros, don't you? I won't say no, but...
Your apprehension stings. I had expected that Alois would have already asked this of you. I must step away for now, but I expect they will desire a word with you soon. Please listen carefully to what they have to say. Until tomorrow, farewell.
I can't believe it. Forced back into the Knights of Seros. I'm sorry I dragged you into this. Looks like I'll be stuck here for a while. And I'm afraid your services are requested as well.
I must work here.
Nothing like that. They want you to teach, by the sound of it. You heard those brats earlier talking about the Officers Academy, right? Well, the Academy just happens to be short a professor. And apparently that damned Alois went and recommended you to Lady Rhea.
So, you must be the new professor. My, how stern and handsome you are.
No. I'm not the one you're looking for. You can handle things from here. Good luck. And watch out for Lady Rhea. I don't know what she's thinking, making you a professor like this. To something. Stay on your guard.
Oh, it's you then? So young.
Competence and age are not necessarily correlated, as you well know. I am Hannah, a Crest scholar and professor at the Officers' Academy. I wonder if you bear a crest of your own. When next you have a moment to spare, I insist that you pay me a visit so we can delve into the subject further.
I'm Manuela. I'm a professor, a physician, a songstress, and available. It's nice to meet you.
And I'm new in town.
Of course. Before I came here, I belonged to a renowned opera company. Perhaps you've heard of me? The Mittelfranc Opera Company is beautiful, peerless.
Spare our colleague the needless chatter, Mother. Now, it seems you'll be taking charge of one of the Academy's three houses. I expect you haven't yet been briefed on the nature of each, have you?
Do you really not know? Fine. I'll do you a favor and explain. The Officers' Academy is comprised of three houses of students, each of which is closely affiliated with its region of origin. The Black Eagle House is for students from the Adrestian Empire. Their house leader this year is Edelgard, the Imperial Princess, who is in line to be the next Emperor.
Blue Lion House is for students from the probably Edelgard. Yeah, definitely. Our house. In the middle of our house.
Lastly, there is the Golden Deer House, which is for students of the Lester Alliance. Their house leader is Claude, grandson to Duke Regan, the leader of the Alliance.
To think that the next Emperor, King, and Sovereign Duke are all here. It certainly is a promising year for the Academy.
I'll say. I just hope none of those little treasures cause any trouble.
Quite. For now, I suggest taking a stroll around the Academy to get your bearings. And when you've a moment, please stop by my research laboratory.
The old man has a point. Oh, and keep in mind that I've only notified the house leaders that you're our new professor. It's more fun that way. I suggest you try spending time with the students. Some odd ducks in that bunch, but they're good kids. I'm sure Lady Rhea will have more information for you tomorrow, but that should get you going. Good luck. You'll need it.
Have you no intention of changing your mind, Rhea? Appointing a stranger, a child no less, as a professor at our esteemed academy is...
I have made my decision, Sedith. I know worrying comes naturally to you, but there is truly no need. That stranger is Geralt's flesh and blood after all.
I can't say that's all too comforting. How trustworthy is this Geralt character? Is he not the man who went missing after the Great Fire 21 years ago? I would remind you that Flayne is now here with us as well. I beg of you, please consider whether this is an unnecessary risk.
Sedith, they have my trust. Let that be enough for you as well. More importantly, I have received a report from Shamir. I am increasingly concerned about a matter regarding our suspicious individual.
Thank you. Wait, why did you remove the ban?
Cannot ignore those who harbor ill will toward the church, especially if they are frequenting Garrick Mach.
There we go.
Yes, that matter is of great importance as well. I shall continue my investigation. Rhea, for now I will have faith that you are placing your trust with the utmost care. I pray that nothing occurs to shake that confidence.
Oh no. Oh no, Ohio. Also, what was that about? There was the person who spoiled things in Danganronpa 2, but in a way that was not believable until it happened. It wasn't them. Also, what was that about? Oh, it's more fun if only the house heads know you're a professor. Like, are we just gonna let that one slip by? You didn't notice? It was so obvious in the first cutscene. Joe, I feel like our eyes are going different places here.
Take a look around the academy and acquaint yourself with your new home. That is your first task here at the monastery. Please let me know if you accept it. Once you have finished, come and speak with me. May I ask a favor of you?
I get an iron sword, 500G, and a vulnerary. You should speak with every student you can. This might be the only your only chance to see what they're really like before you become a professor. Speak to the three house leaders and gather information about the students in each house. The students can be found in the reception hall on the first floor and throughout the officers' academy. Quests are tasks given to you by people around the monastery. Those who can give or are involved with quests will have icons by them. Consult the quest menu to see quests you've accepted. Icons have status. Icons for essential quests are red.
Saved the lives of the students you came across. That, at least, was admirable.
This man already has bastard energy, honestly.
Go around the monastery and see that you greet everyone.
My arch enemy stares. Okay, that is really weird. Stairs. Put him up in the upper right corner. Locations for people, quest givers, more, zoom the map with CR. Okay, that's better. There are people here that I cannot see. Edelgard. Yeah, I'm just listening into conversations because I'm a horrible, horrible eavesdropper.
Pardon me.
pleasure. As for me, my job is to stand here at this glorious entrance and leisurely watch over the comings and goings of everyone. Make folks smile, you know? And by that, I mean to vigilantly guard this entrance with my very life. No levity whatsoever. As of now, nothing to report.
Golden Deer houses for students of the Lester Alliance.
Why is it just a yellow square?
Our house leader is heir to the Alliance's leadership, House Regan. We have plenty of other prominent nobles as well.
Oh, Jesus Christ. You were that mercenary.
Must be that renowned mercenary. Perhaps you'd like to join me for a cup of tea sometime. My name is Lawrence Hellman Gloucester. You will want to remember it.
So you're the skilled mercenary who saved Claude, are you?
Oh, you are? It's such an honor to meet you. Ignatz Victor. My parents are Alliance merchants.
And I am Lysithia von Ordelia. Please do not forget it.
What's like this?
Hey, are you that mercenary? Everyone's been talking about you. I'm Hilda Valentine Gonwell, and her name is... Marianne von Egmont. Are you joining the Knights of Seros or something? Well, I look forward to seeing more of you.
It's not even the first day of class yet here.
Are you someone's guest?
You have Udo.
Dining hall that way, if that's what you're looking for.
No, Raphael. That's Captain Gerald's kid. Hi, I'm Leonie Fennelly, Captain Gerald's first and greatest apprentice. I'm sure he's told you about me.
Nice to meet you. I'm Raphael Kirsten. Who are you again?
To the Blue Lion House. Our house leader is Prince Dimitri. All of us here hail from the Holy Kingdom of Fargus.
Okay.
Well, well, it must be my lucky day today,
being approached by such a beauty. I'm Sylvain Jose Gautier. Feel free to say hi whenever you like.
And who's this? You don't look familiar at all. Do you work here at the monastery?
Is that Mikan? Or Sonia? I'm calling you Mercedes.
I'm Annette. It's nice to meet you.
It doesn't matter about the actual pronunciation.
From Prince Dimitri. As a citizen of Fargus, I thank you.
He also said you're quite skilled. And he doesn't just say things like that. I look forward to sparring with you and beating you.
Felix, must you always speak of fighting right away?
Oh, and, you may call me Ingrid. It is a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Okay, that explains why she sounded so familiar. I think I recognize voices. I didn't know any of those shared a voice actor.
Well, well, it must be my lucky.
Oh, I already talked to you.
Hi there. You must be the one everyone's talking about. I'm Ash. Great to meet you. This here is Dedu. He serves Prince Dimitri.
I have heard that you rescued His Highness. Words cannot express my gratitude. Should you ever require my strength, please know that I will hasten to repay this debt.
Hey! This is the classroom of the Black Eagle House, which is for students from the Adrestian Empire. Our house leader is Princess Edelgard. There are many other nobles among our ranks as well.
What are those low-quality noises? Cat! Cat! Why can I not pet the cat? Ah! Worst game!
Legitimate son of the Iyer family, the Empire's foremost house. Are you going to join our class? I look forward to getting better acquainted with you.
What? I don't talk to strangers.
Bernadetta is definitely one of Sam's favorites. This is...
Have my most sincere This is Petra. She has come all the way from Bridget to study in the Empire.
Lysithia has the same voice act... The same voice as XJ9.
Back on her archipelago, she is actually a princess. In Vodlan terms, she would be called heir to the throne.
Hello. I am called Petra. I am pleased to be meeting you.
Second language? I like how the animals have thicker outlines than the people. You don't have business here. Alright, I talked to everyone out here that I can, besides the actual heads.
Please accept my apologies for the other day. You came to our aid, yet I hadn't even the courtesy to properly introduce myself. I am Dimitri Alexandra Blathid, Crown Prince of the Holy Kingdom of Fargus.
Blathid?
Of course, at the Academy, I am simply a student. And I've heard word that you are to become a professor here. Delightful news. I still have much to learn, but I'm confident I could benefit greatly from your guidance. In any case, welcome to the monastery. I hear you're investigating the different houses here. Did any of the blue lions catch your attention?
I wasn't actually thinking of them as, like, belonging to the houses quite yet, since you can poach. Okay. This freaking nerd.
He's the adoptive son.
Oh, I see. Extra information. Oh, that is a very important defining ability.
He has an extremely earnest personality, so I'm certain he will approach your lectures with great enthusiasm.
Let's go down the list.
Me? Oh, please forgive me. It's difficult to open up on the spot, don't you think?
Oh, there's no triangle. Individual characters have strengths and weaknesses. Multiplies experience earned by 1.2. Is that for the whole party?
I'm afraid my story.
As long as they're deployed?
I do hope that doesn't color your view of me, but I understand if that can't be helped.
Oh, huh.
Dude was born in Duskan and has been loyally working in my service for the past 4 years.
If unit takes no action except wait, grants defense plus 4 for one turn.
He's rather taciturn. Once you get to know him, you'll see he's a...
No defined class.
Felix is the heir to House Fraldarius. He has a bit of a sharp tongue, but don't let that fool you. Deep down, he's a good guy.
Unit deals 5 extra damage when no battalion is assigned, when battalion endurance is 0.
Gravitates toward people who are skilled. Perhaps you would enjoy a friendly competition with him sometime.
So Felix likes rivalry.
He's the adoptive son of Lord Lenato of Castle Gaspar, but I hear he was born a commoner. He
has... I'm going through this again.
Sylvain is the heir to House Gautier.
Oh my god.
He is a capable person who highly values his friends. That said...
If a female ally is adjacent, unit deals 2 extra damage and takes 2 less damage during combat. Jesus Christ.
Well, he's always...
Yeah, there's some nobles, some
skirt chaser,
commoners.
So speak. Pardon my bluntness. I speak with him about it often, but it doesn't seem to help.
Is that a charisma stat? When healing an ally with white magic, unit recovers the same amount of... Oh! Oh, that is so good!
She may seem carefree on the surface, but she's actually a kind soul who pays careful attention to everyone around her.
Assemble by their picture. Okay.
Annette is Baron Dominic's niece. She is a talented student who scored extremely high marks at the Royal School of Sorcery.
Use Rally to grant strength plus 4 to an ally. Is that a turn action or like a bonus action?
She's cheerful and hardworking. Brilliant, really. Though she can be a bit oblivious at times. I hear she caused an explosion in the kitchen last night.
Oh, wait. Strengths are, like, their personal best weapons, I bet. If I had to guess.
Ingrid is Count Galatea's daughter. She is also a childhood friend of Felix, Sylvain, and myself.
Grants might plus 3 and hit plus 5 with gambits.
She is diligent, industrious, and principled. In truth, she is more knightly than most knights you will ever meet.
First impression. I guess that means I'd better introduce myself properly. I'm Claude von Regan. I'm from the ruling house of the Lester Alliance, but don't worry too much about all that madness. I'm guessing you don't know which class you'll be teaching yet, do you? I bet you'd like ours. We're not as difficult as the other two.
Have you met the folks from the Golden Deer House yet? Care to know more about anyone?
interest, have I? As luck would have it, I'm pretty curious about you as well. But what's life without a bit of mystery? Let's just spend the next year or so learning about each other little by little.
Oh, I see. All the lords have a 20% XP bonus.
He's the heir of Gloucester territory. If you haven't already picked up on it, he's a bit arrogant and fancies himself a ladies' man.
Unit deals 2 extra damage while in formation with a battalion.
Said, deep down, he's really devoted and honest. Though I wouldn't mind never hearing him talk about his noble obligations ever again. He's the heir of... That said, he's the... That said, he's the... That said...
Ah! Raphael.
He comes from a merchant family, but his parents died in an accident. Seems like he's had a rough life.
Chance... to recover up to 10% of max HP at the start of each turn, trigger percent equals luck stat.
Despite all that, he's just about the most cheerful guy you'll ever meet. His passions are training, eating, and...
It doesn't fit.
Actually, that's about it. He's the second son of a merchant family. Since his brother will inherit the business, he's training to become a knight.
Grant's hit plus 20.
If you ask me, it doesn't seem like he truly wants to be a knight. He's probably just doing it to please his parents. Lysithia is the daughter of Count Ardelia, and is probably the youngest student here.
Double skill experience earned in battle.
She gets angry if you treat her like a child. As for me, I do it on purpose. You have to make your own fun in this place, you know? Marianne is Margrave Edmund's daughter, and that's... much all I know about her. She doesn't interact much with other students, so I wouldn't be surprised if a lot of folks here have never even heard her speak.
Unit recovers up to 20% of max HP at the start of each turn when adjacent to a cavalry or flying ally.
Hilda is the only daughter of Duke Goneril. It seems her father and brother coddle her quite a bit.
Advocate. Adjacent male allies deal 3 extra damage during combat.
Lazy. Dictionary. Her picture won't be there because she never got around to submitting it. Not too unusual for a noble, I guess. Leone enrolled because she wants to be a mercenary.
Oh, Leone doesn't have
a
icon. If male ally is adjacent, unit deals 2 extra damage and takes 2 less damage during combat.
She's pretty blunt and as stingy as they come. A habitual saver, too. I think she's hoping to repay her village for helping to send her here.
Wow, she has no resistance.
So, you've accepted a teaching position here. Pity. I was hoping you would lend your strength to the Empire. I never properly introduced myself, did I? My name is Edelgard von Gressberg. I am the princess and heir apparent of the Adrestian Empire. I wonder if you'll be tasked with leading the Black Eagles. I hope you've had a chance to meet everyone. Would you like to know more about any of the Black Eagles? Me? Well, some think I'm a bit distant. Arrogant even. But there's little to be done. One day I must...
13 strength!
Restia's next emperor. What else? Well, it seems to me that we may have similar personalities. Hubert is the heir of Monkey Vester. He has served me since I was a child.
Grants might plus 5 with gambits.
You may think his blood runs a bit cold, but actually that's rather accurate. Still, if you can get past that, you'll see he's quite astute and reasonable. For some reason, he thinks of me as a bitter rival and is always trying to challenge me. It's terribly irritating.
Grant's hit avoid plus 15 when unit is at full HP.
His house is that of Duke Ion, which produces Adrestia's prime ministers. That family is, perhaps, too pleased with its own status.
So couple him with a healer.
He's remarkably intelligent, but he only wishes to apply himself to tasks that particularly interest him, and nothing else. He's also fond of, well,
The unit takes no action except weight, recovers up to 10% of max HP.
If he had any work ethic or sense of duty to speak of, I suppose he would be destined to become an official of the Empire. He's the second son of Count Gertrude's. He has no inheritance in his future, which is perhaps why he's always so eager to prove himself.
Adjacent foes suffer a void minus 10 during combat.
He's overly energetic and rushes headfirst into any battle. If he ends up in your care, be sure to keep a close eye on him. She's Count Varley's only daughter. I suppose you could say she's a bit eccentric, but she seems like a gentle soul.
Grants attack plus 5 when unit is not at full HP. Persecution complex, oh no!
She finds her way to class. Few commoners have joined the Black Eagle House, but Dorothea is an exception.
Adjacent allies recover up to 10% of max HP at the start of each turn.
She's a songstress from a famous opera company in the Empire. I'm not entirely sure what brought her to the Officers Academy.
Does adjacent include diagonals?
To the west of Fogland is an archipelago called Bridget. Petra is the granddaughter of their king.
Grants crit plus 20 when foe's HP is less than 50%. Less than or equal to 50%.
Bridget is a vassal state of the Empire, which is how she came to be enrolled here. She's incredibly smart and studious. I appreciate your effort.
Quest complete. Okay, I just got things out of nowhere. I suppose I should return to Rhea.
How are you enjoying your time at the Academy thus far? I hope you have found our halls brimming with the vitality of well-intentioned souls.
I suppose it is time for you to take charge of one of our three houses of students. I must note that I am personally against entrusting someone as lacking in trackable history as yourself with such a task. But it is as the Archbishop desires.
The Black Eagles, the Blue Lions, and the Golden Deer. All so different. I hope you've made it a point to get to know each of them.
Since you are new here, we have decided to allow you first pick. Manuela and I will take charge of the remaining two houses.
Like I said, Black Eagle.
You've chosen the Black Eagles led by Edelgard, correct? Your heart has made its choice then. All I ask is that you guide these open minds with virtue, care, and sincerity.
They are all promising youths who bear the weight of Fodlin's future upon their shoulders. I hope you appreciate what an honor it is to lead them.
Brother? Oh, I am so sincerely sorry. I did not mean to interrupt.
I am in the middle of something, Flame. Is it urgent?
No, it's nothing. More importantly, who is this?
This is our newest professor at the Academy.
Oh my! A new addition to the Officers Academy! I am so very pleased to meet you, Professor. I am Seth's little sister, Flame. I am so happy to make your acquaintance.
Let us focus on the topic at hand. There is something you should be aware of. In a few days' time, there will be a mock battle between the three houses, intended to gauge the current progress of the students. We will be using this battle as an opportunity to ascertain your own abilities as well. Please do not disappoint the Archbishop. That is all.
Our new professors. You? I didn't see that one coming.
Easy, Caspar. Aren't you being a bit rude?
You know it's a waste of time to expect politeness from him. It will be a pleasure learning from you, Professor. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm off to take a nap.
Ah. I didn't put it in so many words.
Don't look at me like that. Oh, and please don't talk to me too much either. I'm sorry for the chaos you've walked into.
I hear we are rather close in age, Professor. I hope you do not mind if we treat you like one of us. In our class, we try to treat each other as equals, despite any differences in age or status. Personally, I would love to include you in that inner circle.
You don't even have a choice.
You have a gut, Professor. I will take great joy from your teachings. Petra, I believe you mean to say that our professor has guts. That's a bit different from having a gut. You can't go around saying someone so slim and attractive has a gut.
Oh, all right.
Please take my apologies. I have not yet mastered this language.
I noticed.
Professor, I want you to know that it's perfectly acceptable for you to treat me as you do the others. I may be the Imperial Princess, but here at the Academy, I'm just another student. That said, know that I have high expectations of you, and high hopes. But I'm certain you can lead the Black Eagle House to greatness.
Sure, sure. Now let's break the ice with a training session. I want to see our new teacher in action.
Why will the ice be broken? Is this a custom I have missed in my studies?
Not real ice, just the ice of, well, it just means let's get to know each other.
I don't want to train. Let's stay in the classroom and learn from a book. Let's all calm down and have a nice cup of tea, how about? Doesn't that sound lovely, Professor?
I know we all agreed to treat each other as equals, but there is a limit to what I can tolerate. The esteemed Black Eagle House requires order. Like your first job will be to quiet down this racket. I don't envy you.
You're not normally this rowdy. I do hope you can manage, Professor.
There are new places to explore in the monastery. Received 1,000 G from the Church of Saros as funding for this month's activities.
Say, while you're here, I'd like to use this device I designed to determine whether the power of a crest resides within you. Won't hurt a bit, promise. You don't know about crests? Well, allow me to tell you everything, absolutely everything, about them. Is your calendar clear? This will take a while. Crests are a fascinating topic, but before one can dive deeply into said topic, one must first understand what crests are. They are power incarnate. They are said to have been bestowed upon humans by the goddess countless ages ago. They exist within the flesh. Passed down through bloodlines.
So it's Grand Crest War.
Those who carry crests may excel at magic, display exceptional strength, or any number of boons. Each crest has its own power, the nature of which is beyond mortal understanding. For now. I suspect as much, yes. But we won't know for sure unless I look into the matter. As I said, crests are passed down through the blood. However, just because someone carries a crest does not necessarily mean their descendants will inherit it as well. Only a scarce few descendants of a crest's bloodline end up inheriting that crest's power. Perhaps one of your ancestors bore a crest, and you just happened to inherit it. That is how a crest usually presents itself, after all.
Crests are stored in the blood.
Yes, of course. I'll get to the bottom of it straight away. Now, please go ahead and hold out your arm over this device here.
I like how Byleth always wears that gauntlet.
A pattern I've never seen before. Is it possible an as yet undiscovered crest has been detected? To think there are still crests out there that even I am unaware of. How thrilling! Pardon my unrestrained jubilation. I have much to consider. You may leave now. I have more research to do in regard to this crest. Yes, so very much more research. But for now, your work here is done. What could this rhyme here be indicating? Perhaps it represents a lack of symmetry. Perhaps. What in the world? Oh, I see. It may be connected to that, but to a greater degree than usual.
It's now possible to go into battle with the same appearance as in the monastery. You can now change the protagonist's outfit to the dancer's ensemble in your journal. A quest has been added from Chapter 5 of the main story on. You'll find this quest via the bulletin board. In order to accept it, you must have the ability to invite people to tea parties.
Professors of the Officers' Academy receive a schedule for the month ahead. It notes the days on which events and missions will take place that month. Pay careful attention to your schedule, so that you may thoughtfully plan what you intend to do each month, and when.
The monastery's schedule features different events on different days. Each week you'll have one day off when you can choose an activity from the list. Your only option at first will be explore. Right, because it's basically Princess Maker. In the management regard. So, this is my room. Thought I heard a girl's voice, but I must have been imagining things.
That's a lot of dialogue!
Okay. Unit appearance. Why is specifically the dancer class outfit? Is it the only one that has a different outfit? Let's see here. Quest information. Fresh catch. Greetings all. Please assist me in catching a delectable fish for this St. Cythlian celebration. Yeah, it's just, I'm not sure why. I'd like some help growing vegetables. Oh, Flayne, Didu, and Sylvain. Food in the dining hall is pretty appetizing. Is anyone interested in sharing a meal? Ladies preferred. And no weekly announcements. Visit the dining hall to unlock the ability to... Oh, I see. These are just what I can do today, and I just go to them. Dormitory and dining hall.
These are the students' quarters. To better help you supervise them, you also have a room here. Your room is here at the end. Commoner students also reside on the first floor, while the second is primarily for students of noble birth. As a rule, we try to avoid discrimination based on social status here. But the nobility can be quite insistent when it comes to matters of propriety. Speaking of, it would be best for you to avoid improper conduct. I expect you to set a good example for the students.
Okay. I'm not too keen on the professor of my class. I really hope to focus more on strategy. Maybe I should talk to my professor about transferring to a different class.
I heard about the upcoming mock battle. I want you to know, Professor, that I do not intend to lose. I hereby declare my intention to prevail and... Goodness, listen to me. The thrill of competition has carried me away. I won't speak so formally of a class assignment in the future.
Yeah, I figured.
Let me know when you are hungry. I will make you a quality meal, as thanks for your service to His Highness.
I have a request.
So do quests take time? Okay.
Let me know when you are hungry. I will make...
Hey, Teach. I hear there's gonna be a mock battle between the houses. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a bit concerned about facing an elite mercenary like you. Maybe take it easy on us. You say.
Oh, Professor, have you adjusted to life at the Academy yet? Me, I'm still not used to it. I'm not one for all this studying and training.
Oh.
Tea of the Saints. Even commoners have tried this cost-efficient tea, which is a mixture of herbs. It's a tad bitter. Arcane crystal, a smithing crystal that glows with magical light. Just, you know, casually pillaging things from the school. No big deal.
Hi, this is the Golden Deer House. You're in charge of a different house, right? Too bad we won't see more of each other. I'm happy to learn from you if the opportunity comes up.
Our house is that of the Golden Deer. Do you know the significance of that name, Professor? Golden Deer are sacred creatures, said to have protected Lester since time immemorial. All three of the houses have a meaning behind their name. You should feel free to ask around if that sort of knowledge interests you.
Join me on a little trip into town? If I'm cooped up in this dusty old monastery for too long, it drives me absolutely crazy.
So Blue Icon is people in your class, right?
Before I came to the Officers Academy, I attended a school of magic in the Kingdom Capital. That's where I met Annie. That's what I call Annette. Oh, I guess Lawrence was at the School of Magic too. But Annie was always just so nice to me, even though I was older. She's my best friend in the world.
The Blue Lion House derived its name from the honorary title of the first King of Argus. Blue, the King of Lions, wore brilliantly blue garments. His chivalric exploits are recorded in multiple legends. The library holds various historical accounts regarding him and the Blue Lions. If you find time, you should read them. They're filled with insights.
Listen. Let me tell you the provenance of our class name, the Eagle. That refers to the twin-headed eagle on the Adrestian Empire's coat of arms. And black is the traditional color of the Empire's armor. Hence, Black Eagles.
Professor!
Okay. Wow, Rita sure seems strong.
A mistranslation of Lug?
I kind of thought he was going to be the new professor assigned to our class. After that teacher ran away during our outdoor training, I figured Yuritsa was a natural replacement. I was surprised when you were suddenly appointed professor instead. I don't think I could hold my own against Yuritsa in battle. Well, I could probably take you, though. You really think so? With enough training, I'm sure I'll beat you someday.
Care nothing of friendship. If you have no business here, leave.
Wait, what is that red?
Okay.
Icon there.
Dimitri and Claude are the leaders of the other two houses. Do not underestimate them. When we take the field, it would be best not to engage the both of them at once.
Some believe the dignity of the Empire rests on the results of the mock battle. That's an overstatement, of course. Still, we must do our best to prevail. You should take the time to learn each student's abilities. Perhaps some extra lessons and training sessions are in order? You look as if you have no idea what's going on here. So I'm happy to help you find your footing. The monastery has some exceptional facilities that everyone who lives at the Officer's Academy is welcome to make use of. For example, you can enjoy a meal with your students at the dining hall, or take part in some one-on-one sparring at the training grounds. I suggest visiting the various facilities whenever you have the time to spare. It's a great way to get to know the students, faculty, and various workers here. Have you noticed the bulletin boards placed around the monastery? Those contain requests people have posted, as well as helpful information from the market. If you prove yourself by helping people with their requests, certain facilities here will become available for your use. The bulletin board is
I thought the facilities were for everyone's use.
At least once a month. You should take your time when speaking with everyone, but when it comes to using the facilities, well, you need to be more careful about that. Use them without planning ahead, your free time will be gone before you know it.
You can explore the monastery as much as you like, but certain activities will only be available when you have activity points. When you're done exploring, press the L button to end your free time and proceed to the next week.
A great deal is expected from professors of the Officers Academy, so to put it plainly, you'll need to keep expanding your knowledge of all disciplines, not just battle.
Your professor level determines your maximum activity points. Raise it by reading books, taking part in activities, and interacting with students. Goals. Oh, this is where you set people to use specific skills. Roster is everyone's actual character sheet. Inventory, so I have two full vulneraries, and everyone else also has a vulnerary. Linhart has the Nosferatu tome and a training sword. But otherwise, Dorothea has thunder and a training sword, but otherwise, everyone only has their default weapons. Okay. Does anyone have any stranger skills? No. Combat arts. Powerful sword attack, none, curved shot, bow attack with high hit, wrath attack, powerful sword attack, smash, axe attack with high crit, tempest lance, powerful lance attack, smash, high crit, and nothing. Battalions. No battalion standing by. And reclassing. Which I can't do yet. Supports. Just check everyone's level with everyone else. Quest log, storehouse, which is where your inventory goes, I think. Yeah. Guide, options, calendar. I can't really see my, like, points for professor level. Unless it's under, like, roster for me. No. Alright, the icon is their crest. Yes, game, I've been around the dormitory already. Top left of the main screen. Yeah, I see it, but I mean, like, the actual progress towards the next one. Okay.
I'm Captain Gerald's first and best apprentice. I can beat anyone, Professor. Even you, if I have to. It may have been only for a short time, but I learned from the absolute best. Right.
Well, there's Dorothea, Hilda, and Mercedes. Lady Rhea is quite the beauty, too. And I must admit, I've even checked out Professor Manuela once or twice. You know, Professor, I think I'm going to like it at the Officers Academy. There are beautiful girls as far as the eye can see. Professor, I've got a small favor to ask.
Torps.
Hello there, Professor. Well, I call you that, but I am afraid I am not a student here myself. Well, my brother would not be pleased if he heard you saying such things. The monastery is kind enough to provide a sanctuary for my brother and I. He's the only family I have. Might you help me with a favor?
Catch a fish for the ceremony. Dining hall. The music is reminding me of my time at Portia, or in Portia, or whatever the game is called.
I'm busy. Do you want something? I can't right now, but let's fight soon. I look forward to being.
I really need to eat. I can't hold out until the next meal. Why can't the dining hall stay open all the time? I need to keep eating if I want to get stronger.
Professor, I hope you know I am having great abilities for reading and writing. But with sadness, I still have struggles with speaking. If my ways of speech are causing a burden, I hope you will have forgiveness.
Okay. Oh god, I missed people up there.
Princess, the Crown Prince, and the heir to the Alliance's leading house. This is one exceptional year, that's for sure. If you're a teacher here, you better watch your step. If anything were to happen to those kids, well, suffice to say that it could harm the reputation of the Church of Saros, which we've spent almost a millennium establishing. The Great Tree Moon is the best time of the year for naps. Perhaps I could just forget all about my assignment.
Hi there.
Yeah, these sleeves sure are a thing.
I'm a little busy. I really can't right now. I got a lot of things to do. Work and stuff like that. Why don't you look at the flowers in the greenhouse instead? They're pretty.
And back up we go. Oh god, that sprinting animation too. It's not quite Noctis's sprinting animation, but it's close. Yeah, I like JRPGs.
Hello, Professor. I have a teeny tiny question for you, if that's all right. You haven't seen a man with hair the same color as mine, a scowling face, and a generally gloomy demeanor, have you? Well, yes. It's a bit difficult to explain. Please just let me know if you do see him, okay?
Yes. I hear a member of House Resmo, the ruling family of the Empire, has entered the Officers' Academy for the first time in ages. It is said that the Adrestian Empire's very founding was aided by none other than Saint Seros. That is why the crest of Seros is on the Imperial flag. In recent years, a rift has developed between the Empire and the Church. Let us hope this will be a good opportunity for both parties to reforge their close relationship of years past.
There are two types of crests. Major crests manifest their power most effectively, while minor crests are slightly weaker. It is said that the closer a person's blood relation is to various saints and heroes, the higher their chance of bearing a major crest. Of course, there are also examples of major crests manifesting in children whose parents bear no crest whatsoever. The exact nature of how and why crests are inherited is still a mystery. Have you gotten around to visiting the library yet? It's absolutely loaded with valuable information. I only wish I wasn't burdened with the necessity of sleep, so I could spend all my hours there.
I like Lysithia.
In a manner, yes. But it's more that I want to learn as much as I possibly can.
Ugh. One more person. Hello again, Alceris.
By the by, have you ever regretted a decision and wished you could go back and undo it? It's too bad there's no lesson for how to turn back the old clock, huh? But I suppose a bad decision isn't worth all that fuss anyhow.
Alright. All of these quest options are going to take time. But if fishing gives the most professor level points, then I should probably focus on that first. I see a button in the surface overlap to reduce the stamina of the hooked fish. Once its stamina is depleted, you'll have successfully caught the fish. If your line breaks, the fish will escape. Durability of the line increases the professor level. Repeated excellent timing will create combos that reduce the fish. It's a rhythm minigame? We're already playing Lost Odyssey? Carassius. The small fish is common to all regions of Fodland. It is somehow connected to St. Sethian. Gardening doesn't take time either, okay.
Oh, did you come to look at the plants too? The greenhouse here is really incredible. There are so many rare flowers I'd never seen back home, and herbs I never even knew existed. My adoptive father is the real expert. He taught me everything I know about herbs, including how to tell them apart and how to make medicines. You should try looking around the greenhouse sometime if the mood strikes you. Maybe something will catch your eye.
By gardening, you can harvest all kinds of crops. Flowers, for instance, make great gifts. Some people might even decorate their rooms with the flowers you give them. Use a plant command to decide which seeds to use. More seeds mean a bigger harvest, while more compatible seeds will lead to higher quality. Use the cultivate command to pay the greenhouse keeper to look after your crop. The more you spend, the better your harvest will be. Your crop will be ready 1 week after you plant your seeds. Use the harvest command to gather what you've grown. So here I want to plant these. And infuse with magic because it's free.
My thanks.
And I automatically get them. Alright. Oh, I can only have one thing planted at a time. Got it. So let's report to Flayne.
You have helped me so much.
How wonderful. I'm certain St. Sethlin would be most satisfied by this fish. If you ever wish to fish again, simply let the manager of the fishing pond know. 3 herrings, 3 gar, and 5 insect larvae. Alright, let's exhaust this bait then. Actually, let's save first, because I am bad at rhythm minigames. Loach, a beautiful specimen even among Tutates loaches. Cook into a dish that boosts dexterity. Good. Another queen loach. At least fishing is fast in this game. Perfect. Tutates pike. Or Tutates? This fish is a cross between loaches and pike spawned in that lake. Cook into a dish that boosts defense. Loach. Professor, level up. Well, it takes a lot to get past E+. You now have more activity points for exploration, and then receive more monthly funds for activities. Albinian herring, an intense swimmer who migrates over vast distances near the coast of Albania, can be used when you share a meal. Are those weird patterned leggings or tattoos? Okay, so I still only have 1 point, but... 2 fish sauté. 2 types of fish are cut into strips and sautéed in butter. This lavish meal hails from Embar, the Imperial capital. Three bites per bait. All right. So, it may have been technically a spoiler, but I want to get Edelgard up as soon as I can, right? Since I'm doing the Black Eagles. Baked confection coated with Noah fruit cream and a crant reduction, often enjoyed as a dessert at family gatherings. Oh, multiple people. Progression is story locked, so get it as high as the game will let you at any time. Okay.
Oh, I love this meal. How did you know? Ooh, this is my favorite. You've got great taste.
Bonds among the three of you grew stronger. The two you invited are more motivated. You'll usually want to finish exploring when your activity points run out. Press L button to do so.
I knew I could count on you.
And Sylvain's quest complete. Renown increased. So what is renown, then? Huh. It's Ferdinand's birthday. Would you like to buy flowers to celebrate for 200 gold? Sure.
Much appreciated.
I have no use for gold yet anyway. Proceed to this month's mission. Mission, Rivalry of the Houses. Formerly a promising young mercenary, you're now the newest professor at the prestigious Officers Academy. Students and faculty alike look on with curiosity as you engage in a mock battle between the school's three houses. So Dorothy is the fan favorite.
It's finally time for the mock battle. This is my chance to measure your worth as an instructor. Do you think you can rise to the challenge?
I haven't really done much instructing, but...
So confident. This will be interesting. Each of us has undergone strict training. We're prepared for anything that comes our way. That means there's no need to hold back. Show us what you're capable of.
Hey there. Did we miss our invite to this strategy meeting? No, no worries. We'll just join in now.
Simply tell me your weaknesses and you're welcome to stay. But is there enough time to cover them all?
Ah, so you can't win unless you know my weakness. Poor princess. You really should believe in yourself more.
I spare no effort in pursuing victory. As a master of schemes, I should think you would understand.
Schemes? Me? I have no idea what you're talking about.
I just spent my 5 bait, pretty much.
Hearing the words fair and square from Claude could only be a bad omen.
Your highnesses haven't known me for very long, but you already have me figured out, don't you?
No need to boat fight. I will fight with honor. That said, I will fight to win.
Yes, and the same is true of us. Right, Professor?
If that is how you feel, then I will not hold back.
Oh, how precious. Looks like you and the students have become fast friends.
While I am pleased that you are taking the initiative to acquaint yourself with the students,
I'm afraid it's about time for the faculty strategy meeting.
Ah, how time flies. In that case, I'll see you later, little guard.
Professor, be careful out there.
Why, thank you so much. I have gratitude.
Magic can provide new means of attack and defense to a unit that has the skill and is of an appropriate class. You must equip attack magic in place of a weapon, but you can use assist magic regardless of your other equipment. All magic has limited uses, but these will replenish at the end of a battle. The magic your units gain access to is determined by their skill. Study reason to learn black or dark magic. Develop faith to learn white magic. Choose the units option to determine whom to send to battle. Press the A button to toggle a unit. Units highlighted in green cannot be excluded. Choose the inventory option to sort items, equip abilities, or combat arts. Assign battalions or change your units' classes. Choose the map option to see the area and placement of your units. Once your preparations are complete, select fight to begin. Alright. Let's see here. Conditions. Route the enemy. Enemy units 10, makes sense. 5 per house. Now, are they gonna fight each other, or... Oh. Manuela has a vulnerary that she can drop. And Hanneman has an intermediate seal. Allows unit to take the certification exam for an intermediate class. I think I'd go for him first. Forest. You have Miasma Delta. Basic Dark Magic. 5 might, 80 accuracy, 1 to 2 range.
As you wish.
Ferdinand von Eyre.
When is it to see the danger map? There we go.
Stay focused.
None of your shallow tactics are required, Claude. It Knots and I will dismantle the opposition.
Me? But I'm not ready.
Are you making light of our new professor? If you drop your guard, you're gonna get hurt.
Ash, can you move to the front lines? I want to lure the enemy this way.
Got it, Your Highness. Leave it to me.
Once you finish preparing, make your move. Did you? Arcetus, keep our enemy occupied until then.
I'm on it.
Oh my. We'll try our best.
Okay, so now, Ferdinand, you go up here. So I have to move and then take the action immediately, right? I can't hold the action. Just a basic attack works. So, like, if I move a unit, I have to immediately start them attacking or taking their action. Smash has a chance to higher chance to crit and instantly KO. It was worth a try. Ah, but I can then use my asthma. Byleth, you go up here. Linhard, you start making your way up here, but you're actually going to go around that forest to avoid the slowing effect.
I may have to take this seriously after all. Let's use the forest to set up an ambush. I'm counting on your support, everyone.
You take the chance to take Ignatz down.
I've lost. The new professor is quite a commander.
Witness my power.
Then move. Move Ferdinand up here to attack Ash with a basic attack. Ooh, Hubert is going to take a counter here, I think. Yeah. So first, I want Byleth to come up here. I'll come over here. Get at least some support points here. I don't want to quite finish you yet, but I don't have much of a choice. Go up here, and you also start heading up there, around this way. Have the mages go around to the right.
Are you really gonna fight two houses at once? An impressive display of confidence. This is a good opportunity for us. Let's forge ahead.
Seals are for unlocking classes in this series, right? Okay, so Manuela is getting involved, but Hanneman isn't. You know what? There's really not much else we're gonna do, so charge ahead. There. You go up here and probably should have used a vulnerary, but oh well. Alright, Dimitri, you are definitely the next target. Oh wow. That was a bad blow trade. Okay, bye, Linhard. Oh! Times two, though. Mercedes gets another... Wow. Okay. Forests are powerful. I want to move you up here first. No. I'm playing casual. Yeah, just go for it. Because that's going to level you up.
That won't do it.
Oh.
Perhaps I should retreat.
Yeah, you assist, heal. Actually, since you heal the same amount, move over here. Oh, wait, what? Oh, no, it's only adjacent. Well, assist, heal Edelgard for that self-heal from your crest. Okay, crests have to proc. It's not always... Wait, what? Was that not you who has that skill? Crap. That was someone else in a different house. Ferdinand, you get the finishing blow. Because you're still level 1. Alright, Linhart should have used a vulnerary, but let's move on with our lives. Go ahead and Wrath Strike. Mercedes. Crit? No. Which is actually good because I wouldn't want Byleth getting that kill credit. Of course. Oh my god. Linhart, you're amazing!
I'd like to take it easy.
Linhart, Hubert, and Ferdinand all need levels. If I attack you... No. Edelgard, you don't need... I'm gonna have Ferdinand come... Alright, if you don't crit, then someone else gets the kill credit. Oh, he can. Oh, it did. And it's back. No, it's not.
Any experience is worth having.
And it's back. Ish.
My training was insufficient. I am so sorry, everyone. The rest is up to you.